Good morning. It is Friday. It is Friday. I know that much. It is 6:50 in the morning. It's Friday the 28th. I had a little bit of a different day today, so I figured I would vlog. I suck this morning because that's me. I'm not sure why. My kitchen is like really yellow. Okay. I got up at 5:30 with Doug because he needed to go to work. He is getting something done to his truck, so I said I would drive him so we could pick it up tonight. So I just went and did that, and today I am just getting it all done cleaning wise. With school starting this week, I figured I would switch up my schedule a little bit and just map things out better, if that makes sense, and create a weekly consistent schedule for myself. So Monday and Tuesday are my school days where I just focus solely on schoolwork. And then Wednesday is like my grocery prep, food cooking day, errands. Thursday is my free day where I kind of just do whatever I want. And then Friday is like my clean, wash, that kind of like put a ton of stuff away, kind of thing. I spot clean throughout the week, definitely, but like Friday is my day to like Swiffer, vacuum, clean all the counters, clean the cabinets, and all that stuff. And if I have to do wash during the week, I definitely will, but I usually don't. I'm fine doing two or three loads in one day, folding it all, putting it all away. I ran the dishwasher. I usually do this at night. Totally forgot to do that last night, so it is running now. I just got home. I also just got this Keurig. This is the K Slim. It was from Target and it was on sale, and I had a coupon too, so it's awesome. I think I paid like $55, $60. I didn't want the mini because I like having the three different sizes, and I just use this cinnamon dolce Starbucks K-Cup. And then I got this from Target too, the salted caramel, and it smells fantastic. These are my little K-Cups. I'm a very like writing-oriented person, so I like to have things listed and then I like to cross them off. It just makes me feel accomplished. This is Doug's little reminder. So I have the dishes, the wash. I have two loads, so I'm gonna fold and put away two. Then I'm gonna go to the kitchen, baby's room, bathroom, living room, spare room. I don't have to clean our room because I did that already, like 2 days ago. And then what I do in each room is vacuum, Swiffer, clean all the mirrors, and then do the countertops or surfaces, and then put stuff away as well. That's kind of like in this. So yeah, I'm going to get started before my mom gets here. This is the laundry detergent that I use, the All Free Clear. I've used this for ever and ever. And this light, I'm sorry if like it's bothering you. It's bothering me too. So yeah, I love this stuff. My skin is super sensitive, and I feel like everybody says that, but I'm actually like really allergic to dyes and stuff. Even when I was little, I couldn't use like normal kids like bath washes and stuff because my skin is so sensitive. I'd break out in hives. I'm like legitimately allergic to dyes and stuff. I don't like my clothes smelling like something, if that makes sense. Like, I don't like scented laundry detergents or fabric softeners. I just think that's weird. Like, I don't want my clothes, I just want my clothes to smell like, I don't know, my house. Maybe me, unscented. I figured I would do part of this video as a voiceover. So right now I was just making breakfast. I have been on a smoothie kick lately. I just use Greek yogurt, some frozen fruit and collagen and water to make my smoothies, and they are absolutely perfect. It just hits the spot every single morning. Oh, good source of protein and fiber. This is super random, but this is like my favorite part of our house. It looks out onto our street, but these are like my birthday cards, and this is from my mom, and this is from my mom, and this is from one of my really good friends, Sydney, and I just want to keep my cards there because they're really pretty. But this just makes me so happy, and I'll step back so you can see. It's like with the shutters and everything, it just makes me feel happy. And I hate that I can't really open, like, I guess I can open these back ones too. I just don't have anything back there. But then it's like when you open these, it's just, I guess I could go like that. I don't know. But that whole setup just makes me feel happy. I start my cleaning off with vacuuming. That just makes the most sense to me. But going back to my shutters, a lot of that stuff I got from TJ Maxx and Hobby Lobby, and then the aloe plant I got at Aldi a few weeks ago, and I have no idea how I've managed to keep it alive, but I have. It's still going strong. And I get my candles from TJ Maxx. I love the DW Home brand, I think it's called, but that is the giant lemon one. I've had that for months. My hair is a little bit crazy, but I just switched the wash over and vacuumed the whole house. Household cleaning products are either Method or the Mrs. Meyers. They're both available at Target, or I get them online, but I just got the new fall scents of the Mrs. Meyers cleaners, and I am so excited to start using them. But I also use either Comet or just baking soda to clean my sink, and I feel like that cleans the stainless steel beautifully. Honestly, who needs the weather channel or app when you have naturally insane hair? Now I have to re-vacuum my bathroom because my hair is insane. I'm just gonna curl it really quick because I can't keep like looking at myself. Today is supposed to be really humid and disgusting. What's new? Welcome to New Jersey. I don't mind the heat in summer. I do mind the humidity because it just feels disgusting. And nobody wants to deal with that, so. I have no idea what curling iron this is. It's a Hot Tools, and it's like the tapered barrel. I just curl my hair in big chunks away from my face. This is really cutting into my cleaning and getting stuff done. I'm on like really weird time crunches, schedules today, and it's making me a little bit stressed out. I have to be like 1,000 places at different times today, and I haven't worked out yet. I haven't done anything. A beautiful day, the sun is shining, and I am blessed that I have so much to do. This is my favorite bathroom cleaner. It's the Method eucalyptus and mint. It smells really good. And I just have a rag and my cleaner, and I just wipe down the counter. Honestly, no. I don't like the smell anymore. Today's gonna be my third rest day in a row, and I took a ton of rest days last week, so I have no idea like what is going on with me. Like, if this is, obviously it's pregnancy related because I haven't done anything different, but it's not like something is like inherently wrong. Like, I would have called my doctor. I just feel like things are changing in my body, if that makes sense. The only way I can describe it is like, everybody knows how their body naturally feels on a day-to-day basis. And when you change something, of course, like, you might feel different, and then you know, oh, because I did this, like, I ran 6 miles and I normally walk 2, you're going to be sore. It's like, you expect that change and to feel that way. But when you are being consistent and something, you just feel like lethargic, or like you get like GI digestion issues or something like that, or you're just feeling like run down, your normal like activity that you do on a daily basis is just like feels like a lot, and it's not psychological. You know, like, just something's happening, and I don't know what it is because I've literally never been pregnant before. So okay, now my hair is finally how I want it to be, like, not that frizzy. And Doug calls these my whiskers, like my little baby hairs, and they got so long. Okay. Bathroom is... I have hair everywhere. This vacuum, like, we all make fun of my mom so much for her little dustbuster. Because it's like, she walks into my house and I have no idea, because I'm usually doing something. And I have no idea that she's in my house until I hear the vacuum. And it's like, it just gives me a little bit of agita when I hear the vacuum, because then it gets me into like cleaning mode. So an exciting thing that Doug and I did this week was pack our hospital bags for Peanut. I am 32 weeks today, and that was kind of, oh my gosh, the general like week age that I saw people pack their bags. It's just nice to have, they're not totally packed. We're like 70%, I want to say. The baby stuff is all done. He seriously just needed like coming home outfits and a blanket. So when I was at Target, I did get some stuff for my bag that I need. First, I'm gonna put this deodorant. This is the Old Spice Pure Spore. I have just makeup wipes. I don't really use makeup wipes. I do prefer, what's that called? A cleansing oil, but I'm just not gonna, I like the makeup wipes just because it's easier. Just to, like, quick wipe your face off and you're good to go. Especially in the hospital, I'm not gonna wanna be like getting up and doing the oil thing. And then I also just got a pack of wet ones, the wipes. These are like tropical splash. It smells like something, and I can't put my finger on what that something is. And I got travel toothbrushes. I'm gonna put these in the packaging. And I have like 5 different bags of stuff. I did bring my cellar water too, and some cotton pads for my face, just to kind of wipe that off. These travel toothbrushes, because we use electric toothbrushes, and I just don't feel like lugging them around with me. And I know that, like, in the heat of the moment, I'm gonna forget to pack them, he's gonna forget to pack them, so it's just nice to have that. And they're small. I don't feel like bringing 2 big electric toothbrushes. Q-tips, and then this dry shampoo, a travel one. This is the Not Your Mother's. I usually prefer the Batiste or the John Frieda, but whatever, I just admit the trial size. A travel shampoo and conditioner, just in case I have to wash my hair. I don't plan on it, but again, it's like, you never really know what's gonna happen. If I don't want to be like a gross and sweaty mess. And I just got this little travel toothpaste. And that's it for like travel size stuff. It's going in my bag. I'm just gonna put all that in. I have the baby stuff in here too. I don't want to say that this is common sense, but this is common sense to me. Like, just very normal to me, I guess. But especially with COVID, that's like a whole different thing. But along the lines of, hospitals are disgusting. Even when I was little, my mom, every time I had to go to the ER or the doctor's office, it's like, you get home, you immediately take those clothes off at the door, put them into the washing machine, and either run the wash or you shut the washing machine door and like wash those clothes, wash your hands, don't touch your face, like that kind of stuff, because the hospitals are gross. And like, I mean, me and my mom always like took it a step farther and like wiped the car down. But hospitals are not like the cleanest places. Like, you can pick up germs there, you know, there's sick people, whatever. So I've always been like that. And that's why I'm using these Ziploc bags. And yes, like, it's a ton of plastic bags and it is a little bit wasteful, but I feel comfortable using my makeup bag in the hospital and then bringing it home and just like putting it back in my drawers, if that makes sense. That's just me. That's my personal feelings about the hospital. Same thing with like slippers and stuff. Like, I'm just getting cheap slippers for the hospital. That way I can just like throw them away, or if I like don't feel like cleaning them, it's like no love lost. Same thing with like shower shoes. It's kind of the same thing as like the gym. You wouldn't really want to go barefoot in a gym shower, just even if they aren't cleaned. It's like, it's just a communal type of situation that you want shower shoes. You don't go barefoot in the hospital, barefoot at the gym. That's just always how I've done things, and I'm not trying to get like athlete's foot or something. I don't know. I hope that makes sense. So that is all like my travel stuff for the hospital. And then I just need to pack like my brush, my makeup, and that kind of stuff. I don't know what I'm bringing makeup in case I want it. And that way I have it if I look like a train wreck. But I'm not gonna go like full glam. I'm talking like some concealer. It is so much later. And I am home. It's 5:30. I had a pretty busy like afternoon after I cleaned. I met my mom to go on a walk at lunchtime. So we did that, and then I came back home and just had so much to do. Like, it was like little random stuff that like I just didn't feel like doing. Now my neighbor's outside. I've never seen this guy before in my life. Okay, like I was saying, I got home and I had like so many errands to do for no reason. And I was just like in and out of the car. I had to go back to my parents' house because I needed to get something, and it was just like a really long day. And I didn't feel too hot this morning, but I just kind of pushed through. And then with the new like iPhone feature of like when you press the buttons and it does the emergency SOS, my dad did that, and we all thought that like something happened to my dad, and in reality nothing happened. He just pressed the button by accident. So I like drove home for that, and it was really fine. And then I had to go get dog, and we had to pick up his truck, but it wasn't done yet. So it's really in my face. His truck wasn't done yet when we got there. So we had like, I don't know, an hour and a half to kill. So we just like went and like, we went to like this park, and it was just nice. I swung on the swings. Like, I just went on the swings and he ate goldfish. I don't know what is going on with this quality today. I guess because no lights are on in my house. And then we got off the swings to go get his truck. And oh my God, I literally feel like death. I'm not being dramatic. I wobbled off of the swings, and like, just like, oh, my stomach really hurts. I don't know what this baby is doing to me, but like, this is one of the worst days I've had in like a few weeks. I've definitely had my share of like not feeling good over the last few weeks, but it's nothing that I couldn't power through. But this is like, driving home was very hard. And of course I'm like, oh, let me pick up the camera and tell the whole world how terrible I feel. That's just like the reality of being pregnant right now, I guess. But sometimes getting outside and being active will help me feel better. I don't know why, but it just does. And today it didn't really help. So I feel like actual shit. If anyone was wondering, I printed out pictures for Peanut's scrapbook from CBS, and I just picked them up today. I got like 22 pictures for $9. So I'm just going to take my scrapbook stuff out in the living room and scrapbook